In the case of these two bearings, one's got a sealed end, one's got an open end. This one here has open ends on both. So in determining which goes in first, as we're fixing to install these, this has writing or stampings on the side. It says Japan, of course it gives a part number and so forth. So I'm going to leave that to the outside, which is typically the way it's done. Okay, and I have selected a size that will go down inside the hub. But cover the surface of the outer surface of the bearing, which is the immediate surface that I'm hammering on. I don't want to do it on the center, I want to do it on the outside. That way I'm putting the force on the exact surface that is resisting the installation. And you can hear the difference. That solid feel, you know that it is all the way down. Now we're going to do the same thing for the seal. This is the seal that we removed, and we removed it at the same time we did the bearing. So we're going to just put it in with not near the force. And that's fully installed. Now if you remember, we did this in reverse order so that when we turn this wheel over to install this side, we know exactly the sequence that this went in. We'll put a little bit of grease on this, and I'm doing this mainly for just protection and having some type of coating. That's the sequence that we took it out. But as you can see here, the spacer just dropped in. Again, I'm putting this bearing in with the outside, the closed surface to the outside. And that's the perfect size. That'll go down into our hub, also will support our bearing outer surface, okay? Just as we did before. Okay, you can see what's going on here. We make sure we drive down straight.
We're below the surface of the hub. We're going to keep driving till we hear the sound change. Completely different sound. We know that we are bottomed out. Not an excessive amount of force. Something is wrong if we have to hit it with a bigger hammer. If you wish you had a sledge, there is something wrong.
Here we're going to reinstall the seal. We've got the bearing driven all the way in. We'll take the seal, put it on there. Now here we need to go straight and even. We don't need a lot of pressure. Again, we're listening for that sound. We're square, we're straight. We've got a seal driver. That fits.
We've got that sound we were looking for. The seal is in there, it's in there straight, and we are ready for assembly.